This is Uprising. I'm Sonali Kohatkar. In addition to listening to Uprising on KPFK and KPFA, you can now watch our program on Free Speech TV, Dish Network Channel 9415, DirecTV Channel 348, and streaming live at freespeech.org at 3 p.m. Pacific Time, 6 p.m. Eastern every weekday. Now, you can also watch our shows on our brand new YouTube channel at youtube.com/uprisingwithsonali. Please check out that channel and subscribe. We need to reach 1,000 subscribers by the end of the year. That's youtube.com/uprisingwithsonali. The grand jury that has convened to decide whether or not to indict Ferguson police officer Darren Wilson could announce their decision anytime within the next 2 or 3 weeks. Officer Wilson shot 18-year-old Michael Brown multiple times in the St. Louis suburb of Ferguson this summer, sparking the most pronounced anti-police brutality protests in years. Now, officials fear that a decision to not indict Wilson could spark more protests and possibly riots. Ferguson police, who came under fire for a draconian and militarized response to the protests, are apparently readying themselves for more of the same. The department, which is dominated by whites in an area that is largely black, has spent more than $100,000 on new police equipment. Officers are being trained in crowd control tactics. Adding fuel to the news are reports of higher than usual gun sales in the area. When George Zimmerman was acquitted a year ago in Florida for the fatal shooting of 17-year-old Trayvon Martin, the riots that everyone feared didn't transpire. Could Ferguson be different? Could it be more like the 1992 rebellion in Los Angeles that unleashed a wave of public outrage over the acquittal of LAPD officers involved in the brutal beating of Rodney King? Well, joining us to attempt to answer these questions and more is my guest Erin Aubry Kaplan. She's a Los Angeles-based journalist and writer. She's written for the LA Weekly, the LA Times, Ms. Magazine, and Makeshift. Her book is called Black Talk, Blue Thoughts, and Walking the Color Line, Dispatches from a Black Journalista. Welcome to Uprising, Erin.
Thanks, Sonali. I'm sorry I'm not there with you, but I am there in spirit.
Stuck in Los Angeles traffic, I hear, but thank you very much for
joining us. Yeah, we should do a show on that. It's really bad. Yeah.
Well, first, what are you expecting, given all of the news that's coming out about these fears of riots and this readying of crowd control tactics? Does the Ferguson police know something about the grand jury that we don't know?
Well, I don't know. I mean, this is so unusual. I mean, I'm thinking back to 1992 in Los Angeles where, you know, that was more or less spontaneous. People were really taken by surprise by the verdict in, you know, in the case of the police officers involved in beating Rodney King. This is something, this is what I call Occupy Ferguson. This has been going on for months now. It really has not, there's been really no pause. You know, people have been out in the streets, they've been protesting, there have been developments, Eric Holder's come down there. This is really built day by day. And, yeah, people are ready to do something. What that will be, I don't know. It won't be, I mean, if the officer is not, the charges are not brought, I can't imagine there will be any reaction. But again, what that will be, I don't know. And so I think I'm just kind of watching like everyone else. This is very unusual to me. I can't think of a similar kind of circumstance, at least not in my lifetime. But it's kind of the best of both worlds. You have a lot of organization. People have, you know, there's been strategies. But again, there's always the X factor of what will actually happen. I just don't know, but this will not go, let's just say, if the grand jury does not come up with charges, this will not go unremarked upon. There will be some reaction.